was an earthquake, Brian? Ah, they just did it. Yes, a little bit, if you can. He's hurt, poor thing. The stupid tree. Oh, I need to get this off. I still think we need to back up. I think that's what it is. Wow, that was the moment we were waiting for. Ugh, yeah, this horse has been stuck in the cesspool. Ugh, look at him moving. That is such a sight to see. You have to imagine that this horse is hurting, because when we first got on the scene, this horse was stuck in that cesspool his entire hindquarters. Only his front legs were coming out through the cesspool. Now, he is really allowing workers to work with him here. I'm just going to bring this shot out a little bit so that you can still see it. They're bringing him right into the barn. But the good news here is to see this horse walking on his own, and I imagine that they had vets here with him, but we just want to bring you back to that hole. Look at the size of the hole that that horse was stuck in. They allowed firefighters and the police to really hoist different straps around him and help pull him out. They actually had to dig and then pull him out. Again, his front feet were the only thing showing, but you're seeing him walking into the barn. This is a private property at 436 Oceanside Street, right alongside Kennequot State Park. You can see them bringing him into the barn. I think the best news that I've gotten today is to watch this horse walking, because he could have done some serious damage to his legs, but he really allowed the fire department and the police to work with him as they dug around him. You can imagine, we saw something similar to this yesterday with a worker trapped in a hole. Imagine doing it with a horse who's not able to communicate and has this much activity around him. All people that likely aren't familiar with horses, but the horse allowed them to do their thing, and the horse is now out of that cesspool.